أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. نوين 40 نوين الاعتكاف نوين الخلوة نوين العزلة نوين الرياضة نوين السلوك نوين الصيام. الله تعالى العظيم في هذا المسجد ما الذي أولياء الله علمنا بعون الله وكونوا عونا لنا بالله أسعف نحظى بفضل الله. الله 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 عزيز الله 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 كريم الله 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 سبحان الله 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 سلطان الله أبدي سلطان أزلي سلطان الله. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. مدد يا رجال الله. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول وأولي الأمر منكم. Obey Allah, obey the Prophet ﷺ, and obey those who are in authority over you. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والفجر وليال عشر والشفع والوتر هل في ذلك قسم لذي حجر. Allah swearing by the dawn and by the 10 nights, 10 holy nights, which are these nights, starting, depending where you are, starting tonight or starting last night. These are the special opportunity Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving to His believing servants to reach. Why Ummat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Sayyidina Muhammad, have been given ability not like previous nations. People used to live longer. At the time of Bani Israel, if you to be considered a zahid or a abid, you have to shun dunya completely and go live alone. They say if you do this for 78 years, then they start to call you a man of Allah, Zahid or Abid. Completely devoted to worship. Prophet ﷺ informed us that the average age of his ummah is in the 60s, short ages. Most people, they leave, some leave before, some leave after, but if you average it up, it's something somewhere in the 60s. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Kuntum khayra ummati. You are the best nation to the Prophet's nation. So how are we going to compete with these previous nations? When they were worshipping 78 years, we were not living to be 78 years. And that's where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, showing His love for His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because He knows He is the Rahman Muhadat, He is the mercy sent to all humanity, all akwan. There's no way of being in existence if you're not receiving from that mercy of Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There's no even Ahl al-Irfan, there's no creation. You read some of the salawat of the awliya and the mashayikh, they call him Hijabul A'zam, the magnificent barrier. And they call him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wasitatul wujud, the means for existence. All existence, not our own. Everything you see and you don't see in existence, he is the wasita, he is the means for. They're not saying to us, but this is the reality. If Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he is one of the meanings of the mercy is that he is that barrier of light, because we cannot carry Allah's light nor his tajalli. When Sayyidina Musa says to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, arini anzur ilayk, let me see you, Allah says, you cannot see me, but look at the mountain. فَلَمَّا تَجَلَّ رَبُّهُ لِلْجَبَلِ جَعَلَهُ دَكَّ وَخَرَّ مُوسَى صَعِقًا. But look at the mountain. And when Allah manifested, not himself, one manifested aspects of his manifestation onto a mountain, the mountain shattered. And Musa, this in some tafsir, say he passed out, صُعِق. In some say he died. From looking at the mountain on which Allah tajalla, on which Allah manifested his light upon, he could not carry it. So when they say hijab al-a'zam is as a mercy to the only reason that this aqwan can exist is because Sayyidina Muhammad is barrier so that we can exist, because without him there is no existence. Only he can be in that presence, in that divine light. Nobody else can be. كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس. You were the best ummah that have been created amongst, with whom لما دعا داعينا لحضرته بأشرف الخلق كنا أشرف بأشرف الرسل كنا أشرف الأمم. When Allah has called us through the best of creation, the best of messengers, because of him we became the best of nations. We are ummat who? Sayyidina Muhammad. Ummat Sayyidina Muhammad. Even prophets are happy to be from his ummah, even if that means they don't have the rank of prophethood. It's okay. Nobody can see you now. No. You know. Because it's from above. Technology. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد طب القلوب ودواء وعافية الأبدان وشفائها ونور الأبصار وضيائها. And because we are his ummah, Allah gives غير حساب. Look, one salawat upon his beloved, Allah makes 10 upon you. Allah. And the ulama said how he what happens to us? He takes us out of the darkness of our, that we are engulfed in, darkness of dunya, darkness of nafs, darkness of hawa, vain desire and attachments, into the light with one salawat. Alaykum salam. And Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. Come, sit again. And when Ramadan, one night equal to 83 years of worship. And then Ramadan finish, what did we have before Ramadan? We had Dhul Qa'dah, now we have Dhul Hijjah. 10 days. Very special days, the best days of the year. In one of the hadith, Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas, he says that there is no deed more beloved to Allah than good deeds done in these 10 days. And someone asked Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas, even jihad? يعني even جهاد في سبيل الله outside of these 10 days, that's not the jihad outside of these 10 days is not better than worshiping Allah in these 10 days. He says even jihad, except for a man who leaves his house and it goes in Allah's way to fight and comes back without any, means he sacrificed his life, his livelihood, his wealth for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you can, if only that level of sacrifice is better than the ibadat in these 10 days that Allah loves. So our duty is an invitation to a feast, to a treasure. It's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, why is he informing us about these days and the importance of these days? So that we read it and we go home and watch TV or surf the internet. Why is he telling us? He's telling us, my ummah, take advantage, take this opportunity. In 10 days, if we sincerely dedicate ourselves, you can fast any, those who can fast, you can fast any of those 10 days. You can fast all of them, but at least fast the day of Arafah, if you can. You can pray, make qiyam, give a specific time every night, maybe wake up, instead of waking up at Fajr time, wake up half an hour before Fajr time, if you are working, and pray. Dua, make ad'iyah, as much as you can. In this, everything you do in these 10 days is multiplied. And we were earlier say in Jum'ah we spoke about Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad, that in this season of Hajj, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is showing us, you know, the manasik of Hajj and Sayyidina Ibrahim building the Kaaba and Sayyidina Ismail helping him, and the whole point, the point of Qurban and sacrifice based on the sacrifices of who? Of Sayyidina Ibrahim. وَإِذْ تَلَى إِبْرَاهِيمَ رَبُّهُ بِكَلِمَاتٍ فَأَتَمَّهُنَّ قَالَ إِنِّي جَاعِلُكَ لِلنَّاسِ إِمَامًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala abtala, tested Sayyidina Ibrahim with his order to sacrifice his own son. His own son who he waited for until old age. When he became a young man, yani when he's not a child, when he grew in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed him that what he told his son Ismail, إني أرى في المنام أني أذبحك. قال يا أبت افعل ما تؤمر ستجدني إن شاء الله من الصابرين. Look at this family. Sayyidina Ibrahim sees the dream three times, and dream of Anbiya are not like our dreams. They're visions of realities. Sees himself slaughtering his own son. He takes his son and he says to him, oh my son, this is what I saw. His son understands, even as he is young. He didn't say, it's just a dream. Maybe that's not what it means. Find another ta'wil. Oh. He says, ya abati fa'al ma tu'mar. Do as you've been ordered. Understood that it was an order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be sacrificed. And he says, I'm ready. You do as, you will find me patient, my father. Look at the taslimiyyah of this anbiya. Look at the level of trust and submission, trust in Allah's mercy. Look how much it shows their knowledge of their Lord. No question. Do as you've been told. This is the family of Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. These are his ancestors. يا أبت فعل ما تؤمر ستجدني إن شاء الله من الصابرين. And then you have اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد. He said أنا ابن الذبيحين. He said I am the son of the two sacrificial lambs, sacrificial human beings that were destined for sacrifice. Is his son, his father Abdullah also was destined to be sacrificed. Alaykum as-salam. أنا ابن الذبيحين. Full submission, full servanthood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Full acknowledgement of the ownership of Allah over them. No, I am. Before that even, when Sayyidina Ibrahim was ordered to take his family, وَادٍ غَيْرِ ذِي زَرْعٍ, to the desert. No green, no vegetation, no water, no people was in Mecca. He was ordered to take his son, newborn son and wife, and leave them there. And Sayyidina Ibrahim is known for his softness. He's known. Inna Ibrahim la halim, awwah. He had a soft heart, cried easily. And he took his only son, waited for him till old age with his wife and left them in the desert. Full trust. Full taslimiyyah. He knows Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He has full trust in him. Even Sayyida Hajar, when she was ordered, when she realized that he's leaving her with her son, and those who are going to Hajj or have been to Umrah, they have to do the Safa and Marwa. Now they cut the mountain. I don't know what they did, but you could see part of it. But when Sayyida Hajar, it is said in the Siyar that when he was ready to leave her, she only wanted to ask one question. She said, "This is an order from your Lord." That's it. Did Allah order you to do this? And he said he was so emotional he couldn't answer. So he nodded. That's all she wanted to know. These are not stories. This is the reality of our existence. This now, Eid al-Adha coming, and the whole Hajj season, the whole manasik of Hajj is to show for what? People want to worship Allah as they like. They want to worship Him. They want to know the hikmah in everything, in the wisdom, why there must be a reason. Whether you know it, the wisdom, or you don't know the wisdom, this existence of yours is that of a abd, of a servant, of a slave that is owned by his Lord, that is created from Adam. You have nothing, we have nothing. We have no claim to fame. We have no reason to say I. Why? How? Why not? He owns you and everything in this existence. And if he wills, you would cease to exist and as if you never existed. الله. What entitlement? What can we claim? Nothing. And that's why in Imam Ghazali's, when he talks in his Asrar al-Hajj, some secret hikam behind Hajj, he keeps coming back to that same point, that this Sha'ira is for you to acknowledge when you go, if Allah grants you to go to Hajj, is to acknowledge you are nothing, you're abd, no more, no less, a slave, and everything you have is from Allah, your Lord. And all you could do is be grateful for everything and show your gratitude to Him. This is the story of insan. And he highlights for us those who attain that level of taslimiyya. The story of Sayyidina Ibrahim and Sayyidina Ismail alayhi salam, and our own Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, who've attained to be real abd, real servant. This is the way, this is their way. As opposed to who? The accursed one. Shaitan. Shaitan, who they're trying to glamorize now. I hear they have shows now saying he was a good one. That he's a real muwahid. Alayhi ma yastahiq. He didn't want to bow down to anybody but Allah. He knows better. Allah exposed his arrogance, exposed his useless claims. There's so much now. The test is still on now. The test is still on. See, if you like to get comfortable. Till today, we are showcased. We are being this story, this saga. Human beings are being tested. Now we have people who say, for example, you don't need Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You don't need his shafa'ah. The only thing will intercede for you is your amal, your deeds. That's what will help you. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, awliya Allah, nobody can help you. It is said Shaitan did not leave one place in the heavens where handspan where he didn't make sajda. He was abid. He was a very hard worker. Deeds. He even was knowledgeable in all the books. Had alim. What was his downfall? No manners. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, adabani rabbi fa ahsana ta'dibi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rabbah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instilled with him, for in him, the manners that Allah loves. Shaitan, with all his ilm and all his amal and all his deeds, when the test came, when the order came, bow down to Adam. He says, me? You want me to bow down to another one you created? Me? And then hikmah, logic. He's arguing with who? With his creator. I know better. He's not as good as I am. How could you ask me this? أنا خير منه. I'm better than him. My matter, my makeup, my physical makeup is better than his physical makeup. You created me from fire and you created him from mud. Huh? Logic, reason, people want. Arrogant. Doesn't matter what you're being asked. It's who is asking you. That's the adab. Allah. Look at Sayyidina Ibrahim. Allah asked him to slaughter his own son. He used logic. My Lord, my son. I waited for him. The question, Allah. See, akhlaq, manners, illa adab. May Allah give us good manners, inshallah. Give us understanding of how to be well managed. Dress us with good manners. We are weak ones on our own. Astaghfirullah. Tawbah, Ya Rabbi. May Allah forgive our shortcomings. But if He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inshaAllah, by the barakah of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and for His love and for His sake, since we are from His ummah, and we are asking, Ya Rabbi, as weak ones in these holy days, to become true servants, to become real ubad, real abid, not ubad, real abid, real servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa min Allahi at-tawfiq bi hurmati al-habib, bi hurmati al-fatiha.